Hey everyone, this is Nick. I got a question from Kate about how to do something that she was trying to do in Excel. This is some anonymized healthcare data. We have some dates here, start date, and then dates and times of when certain statistics happened or I think perhaps vital signs were taken, something like that. She wanted to know if there's a way to highlight each of these cells based on whether or not they happened at or before the start time in column A. So the first thing we want to do is think about calculating time or using formulas with time and dates. We can do that in Excel because Excel treats dates and times as values, but these cells that we have here are not actually formatted correctly because there's a hyphen in between the date and the time. And what we need is for there to be a space between the date and the time. So I want to go ahead and show you what I mean here. I'm just gonna hide these so that we can see this. I'm gonna go ahead and calculate the difference between these two. We should be able to say equals C2 minus A2, and that should give us the difference between the two. But instead, I get this error because these are not formatted as time and date. So let's go ahead and actually highlight both of these cells. I'm gonna go ahead and hold down, I'm gonna click on column A, hold down Control, and hold down column C so that just those two, all of those columns are highlighted, and we're gonna use the Find and Replace. So let's go to Find and Select up here, click on Replace, and I'm going to go ahead and in the find what, I'm just going to type a hyphen. And then in the replace, I'm going to say space. So I'm just going to push the space bar one time. So go ahead and do that and click on replace all. It replaces 30, it made 30 replacements. And you can see, let's go ahead and just maximize these a little bit. You can see that the difference now is a value. It's a negative because this start time and date is lower than, or this time right here is lower than the start time right here. Now I could go ahead and copy this down, and the formula matches. And each of those cells that she highlighted for an example for me are aligned with the fact that these are zeros or negatives. So let's go ahead to the bigger spreadsheet that she sent me and see if we can do this. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, make that find and replace. I'm going to highlight all of these so that we can replace these and make these start times or make these for time and date format. So let's go ahead and say replace. Since I already did the hyphen, it's hyphen and a space. We'll say replace all, and you can see it made 105 replacements. Close it, and look at that. All of those have been replaced with the real time and date formats. Now, if they didn't do that automatically, all you would need to do is highlight all of those, go to the cell format menu right here, click on more number formats, and then click on the time, and you can see if you scroll down, you'll get the date and then the time in military time right there. So click on that, and then you can click OK, and then that will change formally the number formats there. Now let's go ahead and use some conditional formatting to highlight just the cells that are equal to or less than the start time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use Shift Control down to just highlight all of these cells. We're going to go to the conditional formatting menu, click on New Rule, and I'm going to click on Use a Formula to determine which cell to format. Now here's where Excel is pretty finicky. You have to type an equal sign, and you have to put everything here in parentheses. So I'm going to put everything in parentheses, C2 minus A2, and I want this to be responsive, so I'm going to actually put a dollar sign in front of the A because it's going to always reference the cell in column A. Now I'm going to close this parenthesis. So if C2 minus A2 is less than or equal to zero, I'm going to format the cell. I'm going to fill it with a yellow fill. We're going to say OK. And now you can see that happens. Now what I'm going to do is use the format painter to quickly format each of those cells with the conditional formatting that should be responsive to that start time in column A. So I'm going to go ahead and double click the format painter right here. That keeps the format painter active. You can see that little paintbrush icon right there. And I'm going to go ahead and hold down. I'm going to scroll over the cells that I want to reformat. And so you can see that it's not highlighting anything, but that's because none of these times are lower than that start time. When you're finished format painting, just click on the format painter to deactivate that. Now let's go ahead and just type in a new value. Let's say this would have to be before 1023. So I'm gonna go ahead and just say 1022. And there you go, that works. So that could be a pretty easy way to format paint, get the spreadsheet set up in the way that you need to, Kate. If you wanted to also do this, what you could do is click on the entire column here, Format Painter, double click, and then click on the column like this, like this, like this, like this, like this. Unclick that format painter, and now we could go ahead and just see if this works. Let's see, this is gonna have to be before 8:48. So we're gonna do 8:48, and if it's equal to zero, it's gonna highlight the cell. So Kate, I hope this helps. Let me know if it does in the comments. If you all like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you next time.